Hello, and in this video, we are going to learn how to rank scores or values in Excel with a rank function. So you can see here that I have a very simple list of students and the score that they got from the previous exam. Now, what I really want to do is to rank this student group based on the performance in the exam. I want the student with the best score to rank first, and then I want the student with the lowest score to rank last. Now, let's learn how to do this with the rank function. Okay, so first, click on the first cell and then press the equal sign. And basically what this does is that it is telling Excel that we will be entering a formula. So rank, okay, 1, 2, 3, I see it here, tab. Okay, so first we will need to enter a number. What are we going to rank? And this could be the score for student number one. So it could be D6, okay, comma. Reference means that what are we comparing against? So we will need to select the data range, this one, D6 and D9. And because we want to autofill the formula for all the subsequent rows below it, so we'll need to lock the formula. And in order to do that, we can press Fn plus F4. All right, again, Fn and F4 at the same time, comma, and then the last one, order. We will need to decide whether it is 0 or 1. 0 for descending order from highest to lowest, and then 1 for ascending order from lowest to highest. So in this case, we'll need to select descending because we want the student with the highest score to rank first. Okay, so close bracket and then hit enter. Now let's double click on this cell to autofill the formula down all the cells below. Okay, so you can see that student 4 is now currently ranking number 1 with 85, is the highest in the list. Let's try to change the value of the scores around to see if the formula is working properly. For example, I'm going to change the score for student 1 from 55 to 91. And you can see that once we change the score for one student, then all the rank will get automatically updated. Alright, that is very good. Now, what if we want to add new row or add new data? For example, student 5 has a score of 68. Then in this case, we will need to manually click. And not only that, we will need to manually change the formula again because the data will change. Before it was D6 to D9, now it is D6 to D10. So we will need to change it. Then enter and then double click to autofill, and now it will be working properly. So every time the table grows or more text are being added, then we will need to manually adjust the formula itself, and it could be quite time consuming and tedious. Okay, so let me show you a better method to automate this process. Let's delete this. And basically, I'm going to put all the data in a table, and I'll tell you why in a second. So table. Okay, and now let's add another column for rank. So in this case, our formula will be cleaner. So basically, rank. Okay, and the first number is still the same, D6. And then the reference will select the whole range, the whole score column. Okay. And then we will put 0 because we want to rank in descending order. Okay, so close bracket and hit enter. Okay, now let's see what happens when we add the scores from additional student, for example, student 5. Okay, let's say that the student 5 has perfect score 100. Enter and look what happened. So the rank formula will be automatically updated without us having to do any manual work. All right, so next let's learn how to rank value in ascending order. So for example, I have a list of people here, a small group, and then I want to rank them based on their age. I want to rank the youngest first, and then I want to rank the oldest last. So in this case, again, now this is already being put into a table, so that's very good. So equal rank, okay, number, age, and then the reference would be the whole age column, okay. And then here we'll select 1 instead of 0 because we want the lowest value to go first in the list. Okay, so close bracket. And it looks legit. Now let's try to add another person. So person 6, age is 41, for example. And you can see that the formula will be automatically updated, which is exactly what we wanted. So that's it for now. Happy learning and see you in the next video.